In today's video, I'll show you how to create metal PBR materials in Cinema 4D. I'll be using Cinema 4D 2024, so some menus might look different depending on which version you're using. Additionally, I'll be working with Cinema 4D render, not Redshift 3D, Octane, or any other third-party renderer. Let's begin. I already have my lights and 3D model ready. And my renderer of choice is set to standard, not physical. I'll start by creating a new PBR material. To do this, I'll go to the bottom, select Create, then Classic Materials, and finally, New PBR Material. If you're using another version of Cinema 4D, your PBR material option will be under Materials. Once I've created my PBR material, I'll drag it onto my 3D model. Next, let's open the PBR material by double-clicking on it. You should see a new window appear. Make sure you're in the reflectance section and in the default diffuse section. Now it's time to start adding your textures. Go to the layer color section, and where it says texture, we're going to load our image. You can either click this folder icon here or click directly on the bar to load your diffuse image. Select your diffuse image, then click open. I'll choose no here to avoid creating a copy of the image. At this point, you should see the diffuse image applied to your model. If you want to increase the resolution of your material, go to Viewport and under Texture Preview Size, change it to match the size of your material. My material is 4K, so I'll select that option. Keep in mind that increasing the texture's resolution might slow down your computer depending on your system specs. That looks much better. Now I'll go back to the reflectance section. There are two methods for this step, depending on your material. For this one, it's a mixture of the metal and paint, so part of my material is metal and the other part is not. However, if my PBR material were entirely metal, I would load the diffuse image into the color section instead of the reflectance sections. I'll show you both methods in this video, but let's start with this one. Since we've already loaded our diffuse image, let's move to the default reflection section. Here, we're going to load our roughness image. Go ahead and load your roughness image now. I'll select no. Finally, I'll set my roughness to 100%. Perfect. We're done here. Alright, let's click the Add button and select GGX. I'll name this layer Metal to keep things organized. This is also where we'll add the rest of our PBR materials image. Next, under Attenuation, I'll change the setting to Metal. And then the Roughness section, I'll load my roughness image again. I'll select No here, and then increase the roughness to 100%. This is looking good so far. Now, let's load our reflectance image. I'll select No. Perfect. We'll leave the layer color as is, but we need to focus on the layer mask section. Since our materials isn't fully metal, we need to add a mask so the areas with red paint don't reflect like metal. For this, we'll load our metalness image. This is looking good now. In the layer Fresnel section, we're going to change the Fresnel type. When you open the drop-down menu, you'll see two options, dielectric and conductor. Dielectric is used for plastic materials, while conductors is for metals. Since my materials is metal, I will select conductor. Alright, we're done with the reflectance section. Let's move on to the diffusion and load our ambient occlusion image. Next, go to normal section to load our normal map. And finally, to displacement, where we'll load our height map. If you want to load more polygons to your model to enhance the details of your displacement, then select the box Sub Polygon Displacements. I don't need it, so I'll leave it unchecked. Now, I'll do a quick render. Okay, it looks good, but I need to tone down the height displacement. It's too high. I'll reduce the height to 1. Oh, and before I forget, if you're not seeing the displacement applied to your model, it's probably because you haven't unchecked a specific setting. Select your model and under Render Perfect, make sure it's unchecked. Otherwise, the displacement won't appear. Alright, let me do another render. This looks great. Now let me show you the other method for a PBR material that is fully metal, without any paint or other elements. First, create a new PBR material. I'll apply this new material on top of my existing one to start fresh. Next, I'll double-click on the new material to open it. In the reflectance section, I'm going to delete the default diffuse layer. You could hide it instead, but I'll choose to delete it. Then, I'll activate the color section and load my diffuse image here. Let's move on to diffusion and load our ambient occlusion image. Now, let's go back to the reflectance and into the default reflection section. Load your roughness image here. And increase the roughness to 100%. Alright, let's click the Add button and select GGX. I'll name this layer Metal again. Next, under Attenuation, I'll change the setting to Metal. In its Roughness section, I'll load my Roughness image again. I'll select No here. Now let's load our Reflectance image. I'll select No. Oh, before I forget, I'll increase the Roughness to 100%. Perfect. Now, since our metal material has a color, in the layer color section, I'll load my diffuse image. This will add the color to the material. For the layer mask, go ahead and load your metalness image. My metalness map is all white, so it's not necessary, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'll load it anyway. For the layer Fresnel, I'll select conductor, since it's a metal material. If it were plastic, I'd select dielectric instead. Next, go to normal and load your normal map. For displacement, load your height map. And make sure to reduce the height to 1. Alright, let me do a quick render. Perfect, this looks great. You now know how to create metal PBR materials in Cinema 4D. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching Tutos, your tutorial channel. Till the next one.